but go ahead and call the meeting to order because we are streaming to the outside. I'm sorry, we're gonna use the laptop and use that as our audio, so we are streaming. Sorry. The codes work for that. So they did do that. They hired Scott Matula of Aspire Architects to look at that. They've provided us two letters. The first one was related to the building codes, and the second one was related to HVAC. Pat Eyrick, the building inspector for the South Side, has reviewed all of that and is in agreement with what the architect presented in that there is no issues from an HVAC or a building code standpoint as it relates to 29 days or more. So the building inspection department is able and willing and interested in moving forward, and they don't see any concerns with it. So I think at this stage the discussion is, you know, is the committee on board with moving forward? Now, I will say that I believe they have contracted an outside party to help with their management and have been kind of operating independent of the resort. But this will help them with moving forward in the future. So at this stage, staff has nothing really further of concern, and we are recommending approving.
Further discussion?
So moved.
Okay. All right, let's talk one at a time. Dave Gass, you had a comment.
I signed these guys, we're no worse off than we are right now. I mean, this is a chance to maybe see some development going on. At least you got people who have a history of taking properties and doing something with them. Otherwise, the current people are just going to let the thing continue to deteriorate. So I think we have everything to gain and nothing to lose by doing this. Is there anybody else in the lineup to take over this property and develop it? I doubt it.
Okay.
But David, I thought they bought the building.
But they got to get assignment of the lease. If they don't, they technically don't have a right to be on the property. So they have this building they bought that's on someone else's property. I mean, I can't imagine they'd buy the building without getting assignment.
Right. This is like the chicken and the egg.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So the assignment was the afterthought after they bought the building.
Well, as we know with a lot of these self-care properties, is people don't always remember that you have to get these assignments done before you buy the building. You know, we had that, you know, last meeting with the Maximus group, and it's happened on numerous occasions before. People just, because this is such a weird arrangement where you have these long-term leases, that's not typical. People don't always connect the fact that, oh, when you bought the building, you did buy the land. You got to get the lease assigned to you.
Okay.
So I think
I recommend we get transfer lease.
Okay. Somebody want to put that in a motion?
I move we transfer the lease.
Dave Soxy moved. Is there a second?
There are a total of three documents attached. We're only asking the RDA to approve two of them. That's the assignment of rents and the landlord's estoppel certificate.
All right. That can be part of the motion. The assignment and rent of rent and the estoppel.
But if I could just, I mean, I don't have a problem, but that really doesn't make any sense. If you don't assign the rents or the lease, I mean, what are the rents applied to? I mean, or is there a lease between a real estate entity and an operate entity for this?
So maybe I should be a little bit more clear. The third document that's attached is a subordination non-disturbance agreement, and there's some issues with that which they're not able to fix, and that's going to be dealt with down the road. We're comfortable moving forward with that document not approved by the RDA at this point. So I think the lease is being assigned, and the two documents that we're specifically asking the RDA to approve are the assignment of rents and the landlord's estoppel certificate. And as Chad, I think, mentioned earlier, I think part of this relates to them putting all their ducks in a row for their permanent financing.
But Thomas, wouldn't we want to make sure that this lease gets assigned so that we make sure our ducks are in a row, and we don't end up like we have in other situations where we have people on property who are using a previous owner's assignment of lease or ground lease?
We would approve the assignment of lease. We just wouldn't be approving the third document, which is the subordination.
Okay,
so there's three documents attached for the approval: the assignment of lease or rents, the estoppel of the landlord, and the subordination. The bank has asked us not to approve the subordination yet because there's some challenges with it, and they're going to come back at a later date. But we're still going to sign the lease and have you guys prove the estoppel. So two of the three documents.
So I don't have the three documents. I never got an agenda. So one of the documents that's being approved that is assignment of the ground lease with the RDA.
That is correct.
Okay.
Chad, what are they doing down there? What's the proposal?
I do not know at this stage.
Out of curiosity, isn't that something that we as the RDA/city I'm in favor of these guys doing it, but it just seems like, geez, if someone's gonna take over
let me just cut in, Dave, and say we do have an idea, but it's not something I want to discuss in open session at this stage because they're still in the formulation stage. And we're on an open meeting.
Okay. And the chair has a bit of a hard time with putting the cart before the horse. Like, we are asking us to approve something, and then we go back and find out why we approved it and what it was. So, what's the sense of urgency for this? We got to have another meeting next week, do we not?
2 weeks.
2 weeks, we have another meeting on the 28th.
Can we put a closed session in that 2 weeks on the 28th and then bring this topic?
I guess I could reach out to them and try to get more information and see where they're headed.
I would prefer that. Does anybody have a different opinion?
I don't. Chuck isn't on, but he was the one corresponding with Denmark State Bank, and I don't know if there's a timeliness factor to this or not. So, Thomas, did Chuck say anything on that?
Chuck and I, we talked sort of in broad strokes about these documents. I don't know if there's a time horizon that they're working on.
Well, I would assume that if the bank is still working on subordination, it's not quite imminent. Okay. What do we have to do to act on this? Put it to table it until the next meeting.
So we have a motion on the floor to approve it. So either we need to deny that motion, withdraw that motion, and move into hold, or do something with that motion.
Okay. How about if we withdraw the motion?
Soxie, are you okay?
David, you're muted.
David Soxie, you're muted.
Chad, do you recommend we do this with what you know?
I think so. I would say the project will be a good one. It's just that it's in the early stages.
Then I would suggest we leave the motions so it doesn't get followed up.
Okay.
Another 2 weeks is a long time. I'd like to leave the motion stand.
So the motion on the floor is to approve the assignment of lease. And what's the second document, Thomas?
Landlord.
It is the landlord's estoppel certificate.
The landlord estoppel certificate. Okay. Motion on the floor is to approve those two documents. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Same sign. Aye.
So okay.
On the phone vote? That was not clear to me.
So let's do a roll call.
Thank you.
Dave Gass.
Call the roll.
Dave Soxie.
Yes.
Amy Horst.
Yes.
Roberta Flicky-Pineski.
No.
Steve Harrison.
Yes.
James Owen.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Motion carries, and we will proceed. Discussion and possible.
Before Amy. We move on, Chad, can you just encourage them?
Did we lose her?
We lost her.
We lost her.
Charter Internet is not doing well today. Anyway, go ahead.
Bert, I am going to have to leave. I've got to meet at our other plant, so I've got to go.
All right. Thank you, Steve.
Thank you. Sorry, everybody.
That's fine.
Well, let's move on until she hooks up.
Okay. All right. Discussion and possible action on landlord release and consent regarding 520-830 South Pier. I just got a text from Amy and her computer crashed.
So this,
okay, discussion this, possible action on landlord release and consent 528, 530, and 534, 538. Chad, what are those two places?
So these are the ones we talked about last week. These are the two properties on South Pier the last time we met. This was a another document that the Oostburg State Bank is requiring to basically release rights and consent. And I don't know if Thomas knows a little bit more about these document, this document, but it's a separate document that they should have, they needed us to assign the leases to, and then the bank is looking for sign off on the RDA of that. So that's why this document has come in independent of the other documents. So I guess this happens after the, it's the red building on South Pier where the Islander Cafe used to be and the Rock Shop is in, and the three shop shanty where Bridal Essence used to be and the Honey Hole is in. So those are, we approved assignment of lease to Maximus last time we met. And this is a third document that the bank is requiring prior to closing. And they couldn't execute this document until the assignment of leases were in place.
So this is a document requested by the bank following the two previous documents we've already approved.
That is correct.
Okay.
Move to approve.
Okay, Soxy moved to approve. Is there a second?
Second.
James. By Owen. Okay, any further discussion?
Bert, I didn't realize that this was the people. I'll abstain.
All right. Let the record show that Dave Gass abstained. Okay. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. James Owen, we need a voice from you.
Yep, aye.
All right. Opposed? Hearing none, motion carries. Okay. We've had a warning of technical issues. Thank you for your, here comes Amy again. Amy, would you like to finish your comment that you cut off? Or
I was just going to say, I asked Chad if he could talk to the new owners and ask them if they could bring some more further information into closed session in the near future to maintain good working relationships with the RDA, if you could relay that information.
Will do.
As we did sign off with very little information.
Okay, hearing that, we'll make sure that gets on the agenda for another meeting. Okay, I think we have gone through the order of the day. Chair will entertain a Dave Gass.
Bert?
Yes.
Just one, I believe this is my last meeting, and I've been on this RDA for a while, so it's been a fun ride, and best of luck to all of you going forward. So, I find the reason at the end of the month. So,
wow.
Yeah,
okay.
So on to new horizons, as they say.
Wow. All right. Thank you very much.
We'll see you again because you represent all the clients we work with.
There you go. Okay. All right. Thank you very much for your years of service. Your legal conversations have been enlightening, and I've appreciated them.
And okay. My pleasant personality, too.
And your charming personality.
No.
Is a good nice it's a little early.
Oh, that didn't go.
Okay. All right. It's been moved to adjourn. Is there any objection? Hearing none, we are adjourned. And thank you again, David Gass, for your years of service.
Thanks.
Bye.
Thank you.